الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد اليوم 21 من شهر رمضان 1442 الموافق ل 3 من شهر مايو 2021 نواصل درسنا في هذا الكتاب المبارك كتاب الله عز وجل والذي ندرس فيه سورة الكهف. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يبارك فينا وفيما نتعلمه. So today inshallah we'll move on to the next story mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah of Al-Kahf. Subhanallah, there's a strong wind here. Subhanallah. We start from the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ إِنَّا لَا نُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, after he talked about the position of those people who decided to disagree with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and disobey him, and he told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not to worry about them and to move on, to carry on with the da'wah, not to worry about those people who are not willing to accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us another also option for people to choose. You know, we don't have only that one. That is also another place. If a person wants to, stay away from that tragedy which is mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our tafsir last week. You know. So he says, "Inna al-ladina amanu wa amilu salihati, inna la nudi'u ajra man ahsana amala." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who believe and they put their faith into practice and action. They practice the faith and they maintain the istiqamah on their faith, meaning they believe in anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted them to believe in. And wa amilu salihati, and they participate in righteous deed. So not just iman, but they put that iman also into action. Allah says, "Inna la nudhi'u ajra man ahsana amala." We will never waste the reward of that person who perfects his deed. So when you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you practice that faith and you put your faith into action, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Don't worry, your reward is with us, and we will never neglect any part of it, and we will never waste any part of it." SubhanAllah. So what is this reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing for somebody who has iman and also attached to the iman al-amal al-salih? What is that reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising him? قَالَ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ. These one are given jannah by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these are the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is granted جَنَّةُ عَدْنٍ. There's the jannah that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw when he was taken by Jibreel alayhi salam in that dream. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ, they will be the inheritors of the jannah. تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ أو تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ. There will be rivers going underneath. You know, subhanAllah, you know, nowadays one of the most expensive places are the places under the sea. The places are on the sea, you know, you have a hotel on the sea. The price is going to be a bit high because of the good view you are going to have. So subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that your jannah is going to be placed on top of the water. You have different types of rivers, you know, and your house is on top of them. SubhanAllah. Imagine a place like this, you know. And all of this is just, how should I put it for you? You know, it just, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted you to come closer to the reality. Or else the reality until you see. SubhanAllah. The real view of Jannah, you can just say until you see, you know. Nobody can give you the most accurate description of Jannah except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all of these things that we are talking about, these are just to bring your attention closer to that which exists in Jannah. Otherwise, my dear brothers and sisters, wallahi, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing for the good ones, in Jannah is far greater than what you heard. That's why Allah says, فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says, you just don't know what I am preparing for you of those things that will bring you satisfaction and grant you coolness of an eye and make you happy in your life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you don't know what I am preparing for you of that nature. So it is indirectly telling you that just exercise patience, you know. Soon you will be taken back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you will see, you know. Those who witnessed that, many of them were, you know, subhanAllah, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let their brothers and sisters know what they are enjoying, you know. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to us about the enjoyment they are, you know, subhanAllah, getting in paradise is something that you cannot comprehend. That's why I said, just wait until you see that, subhanAllah. So Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ عَادٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ. And you have anhar, you know, that's rivers, not one type of river. You have different types of rivers. You have the water itself, which is so pure and clean. And you have the river of milk, you know, subhanAllah. مِنْ لَبَنٍ لَمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ طَعْمُهُ. Yogurt, you know, the best one, made in Jannah, you know, made in Jannah. Not Marai, not what do you call Halib Saudiya, not Abdurrahman, I'm touching your your place, not a Good Day, you know, that we have here in Malaysia, or not any other product. This is made in Jannah, you know, subhanAllah. And you have the honey. Nowadays you're suffering, right? Looking for the correct honey. But the good thing about Jannah is there is no sickness. Even if the honey doesn't exist, there is no sickness in Jannah. No sickness. You don't even need to go to the bathroom. You don't need to, subhanAllah. A very complete and excellent life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us Jannah. So, and you have also the river of wine. The wine that just share name with the wine here in dunya, but the nature is different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا يصدعون عنها ولا ينزفون. You know, the aql is not going to be taken, and they will not have the headache in which the person who is drinking wine usually has. They will not have this. So no sickness, no illness because of that wine, and their aql will not be taken away from them. Allah says, لهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتهم الأنهار يحلون فيها من أساور من ذهب ويلبسون ثيابا خضرا من سدس واستبرق متكئين فيها على الأرائك. الله أكبر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they will be adorned. فيها من أساور من ذهب. You know, السوار, these are the bracelet. You know, those things you put in the hand, you know, and the thing you put on the leg. You know, they have so many types of adornment, you know. Allah Akbar. In this dunya is haram, but in the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you all of those nice things, you know. SubhanAllah. Not just the sisters. The sisters, they have beyond this, you know. They're talking about the brothers, you know. What they have as clothes and dress is unbelievable. That's why the Prophet said, for the wife who managed, you know, a sister who managed to go to paradise, she will be so beautiful. You know, if the brothers are going to look like Yusuf, and you know Yusuf, you know how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him as a beauty, you know. If the brothers are going to look like Yusuf, what do you think the sister would look like? Subhanallah. And the Prophet said that one of them will be wearing, you know, 70 layers of adornment. But that beauty that she has, which is, subhanallah, placed on the skin, you know, and the way she looks, that beauty that she has will refuse to be covered by those layers of adornment. You can see that which is inside. It's so light, so beautiful, so excellent in the way it will refuse. From those layers of adornment, you know, that you put one on top of the other, 70 of them. But still the beauty will be discovered. You know. So that's nothing left except for us to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and go to that place. That's a place of rest, you know. Here, what do you have in this dunya, you know, subhanAllah? And we are fighting, you know. What do you have in this dunya? Look at look at this issue that we are suffering from. For how long? Now it's 2 years, right? And this coronavirus, everyone is tight, you know. Life became very tough, you know. Almost everywhere on earth. Who is happy? Like, even those people who are politicizing things, they are also not happy. They have their own type of punishment, which you will never agree to buy what they are in, you know. So this is dunya. That's why it is called dunya, you know. So all that you need in this dunya is to be patient. Yeah. My dear brothers and sisters, I really advise you to exercise patience. Be patient. And soon you will appreciate your patience, inshallah, when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have these kind of adornments. You know, وَيَلْبَسُونَ ثِيَابًا خُضْرًا مِّن سُنْدُسٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be granting them ثِيَابًا خُضْرًا مِّن سُنْدُسٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ. It's a kind of jewelry, you know, kind of type of fabric which is so light and excellent in terms of its look. And an istabarak, this is a type of al-harir, a dibaj, is a type of harir. So they have that, those type of sundus, and also they have the istabarak. You know. SubhanAllah. These are all nuzul, you know, if you can call all of these things, you know, nuzul. Nuzul is just the introduction. Introduction, you know. What is inside is far greater than what they are having now. So, he says, يَلْبَثُونَ ثِيَابًا خُضْرًا مِّن سُنْدُسٍ. خُضْرًا in their color, green color, very beautiful. As I said, these are just bringing things closer to you. You know, the hairy, the thick one, the best one, you're going to be adorned by it when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ مُتَّكِئِينَ فِيهَا عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ نعم الثواب وحسنت مرتفقا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you will see them متكئين فيها على الأرائك. You will see them lying on their beds, you know, enjoying their life. At الاتكاء is to lie like this, you know. SubhanAllah. That means somebody is relaxing, you know. Just lying like this, looking at the family that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them in paradise. SubhanAllah. And the place is so big and full of things, you know. Ibn Qayyim says it's measured by 2,000 years. did you hear that? 2,000 years. That's the length of your kingdom in Jannah. If you don't want this, take from Rasulullah that he says it's not easy for the believer to see the last part of his kingdom in paradise. That's all you want. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَرْضُهَا السَّمَوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ. The lowest person in Jannah is the one who got from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 10 times of this world. And I'm just trying to bring things, you know, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said randomly. Maybe inshallah our heart will be widely open. We maximize our patience and we hold upon the truth and our religion and make sure that you follow the Quran and Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam firmly, you know, and maximize your patience and don't worry about the dunya and observe wara in this dunya and also zuhud in this dunya. It's needed, my dear brothers and sisters. These two things confirm to us and suggest and directed us and guided us towards doing things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and making sure that whatever you're doing in this life is halal and acceptable. Doubtful matters, you keep them aside. Don't go for them. So as long as we agree that we are not going to stay here forever, then that should be our attitude. So muttaki'ina fiha 'ala al-ara'ik. So they lie down like this on their beds, you know, looking at each other. Mutaqabilin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they're facing each other, subhanAllah. You know, life in Jannah is different life. That's why Allah says, wa innal akhirata lahiya al-hayawan. That real life is a life in the akhirah. Allah says, ni'ma al-thawabu wa hasanat mutafaqa. If you're looking for the reward, which is the most blessed reward, look at this reward. That is Jannah. وحسنت مرتفقا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you are looking for an excellent manzil, the place of staying, you know, look at Jannah. You will never find a place like Jannah. So look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala compared between the two, you know, so that you and I will make a choice. He said, these are the places of the people of hell, and these are the places of the people of Jannah, and now it's up to us to choose which one we want for ourselves. You know? Allah says, بِئْسَ الشَّرَابُ وَسَاءَتْ مُرْتَفَقَ. And here he says, نِعْمَ الثَّوَابُ وَحَسُنَتْ مُرْتَفَقَ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to make the correct choice, you know, to choose the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلًا رَجُلَيْنِ جَعَلْنَا لِأَحَدِهِمَا جَنَّتَيْنِ مِنْ أَعْنَابٍ وَحَفَفْنَاهُمَا بِنَخْلٍ وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمَا زَرْعًا كِلْتَ الْجَنَّتَيْنِ آتَتْ أُكُلَهَا وَلَمْ تَظْلِمْ مِنْهُ شَيْئًا وَفَجَّرْنَا خِلَالَهُمَا نَهَرًا وَكَانَ لَهُ ثَمَرٌ فَقَالَ لِصَاحِبِهِ وَهُوَ يُحَاوِرُهُ أَنَا أَكْثَرُ مِنْكَ مَالًا وَأَعَزُّ نَفَرًا وَدَخَلَ جَنَّتَهُ وَهُوَ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ أَنْ تَبِيدَ هَذِهِ أَبَدًا وما أظن الساعة قائمة ولئن رددت إلى ربي لأجلن خيرا منها منقلبا. So this is an example Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us of two people. You know, He told us that there are two places, right? Two options, two choices given to us to choose to go with Rasulullah or to go with Shaytan. No. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us an example of two people. One of them chose this one and the other one chose that one. The other one chose the other one. You know. It says, give them an example of two people. You know, two people. جَعَلْنَا لِأَحَدِهِمَا جَنَّتَيْنِ مِنْ أَعْنَابٍ وَحَفَفْنَاهُمَا بِنَخْلٍ وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمَا زَرَعًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلًا رَجُلَيْنِ جَعَلْنَا لِأَحَدِهِمَا جَنَّتَيْنِ. One of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him two gardens. You know, Jannah, this is Bustan garden. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, جنتين من أعناب وحففناهما بنخل وجعلنا بينهما زرعا. You have two gardens, من أعناب. You know, he grew in this farm, inab is the grapes, you know, and he has also not the okay, just 1 second. Not just the grape, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also beautified that farm with a nakhl. Nakhl is the date, you know, the palm trees. So he has the farm which is full of grapes, and also in between the grapes they have the trees of dates. وَحَفَفْنَاهُمَا بِنَخْلٍ وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمَا زَرَعًا. And between the two farms also there is plantation. What divides these two gardens also, there are beautiful plants there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كِلْتَ الْجَنَّتَيْنِ آتَتْ أُكُلَهَا وَلَمْ تَظْلِمْ مِنْهُ شَيْئًا. So this is just an example of how many types of trees that person has. It's a very beautiful garden Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him. So he said, كِلْتَ الْجَنَّتَيْنِ آتَتْ أُكُلَهَا. Each and every one of them has given its fruit to the best of its ability. You know, bear fruit, very nice and beautiful fruit was generated from it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَمْ تَظْلِمْ مِنْهُ شَيْئًا. None of them has any deficiency in terms of bearing the fruits. وَفَجَّرْنَا خِلَالَهُمَا نَهَرًا. And inside the farms and the gardens, you have river, you know, crossing the garden. SubhanAllah. So you have the different types of fruits and plantations. And you have these gardens are divided into two. In the middle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put also some another type of plantation, you know. And also inside it, you have river crossing the farms. Allah says, وَفَجَّلْنَا خِلَالَهُمَا نَهْرًا وَكَانَ لَهُ ثَمَرٌ. Some says al-murad bi thamar huwa al-mal, and this person is so rich. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says so rich, you know, he has a lot of wealth and richness, you know. Or you take it as usual, thamar means thimar, yani, he has really a lot of fruit being generated from that farm. وَكَانَ لَهُ ثَمَرٌ فَقَالَ لِصَاحِبِهِ وَهُوَ يُحَاوِرُهُ أَنَا أَكْثَرُ مِنْكَ مَالًا وَأَعَزُّ نَفَرًا. So he was talking to his friend one day, and then he told him, you know, you are so poor, you know, I have more wealth than you, وَأَعَزُّ نَفَرًا, and people who are following me also, people in my circle, you know, they are greater than yours, you know. In the club where I'm attending, you know, I have big and important people come into the place. So people who are attached to me, they are more greater than what you have. You have nobody with you, you know. Subhanallah. That's exactly how it is, you know. You see, the righteous people, they might not have somebody on their side. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always with them. And the people of the dunya, they always have people with them. As the shair once said, رَأَيْتُ النَّاسَ قَدْ ذَهَبُوا إِلَى مَنْ عِنْدَهُ ذَهَبُوا وَمَنْ لَا عِنْدَهُ ذَهَبُوا فَعَنْهُ النَّاسُ قَدْ ذَهَبُوا. رَأَيْتُ النَّاسَ قَدْ مَالُوا إِلَى مَنْ عِنْدَهُ مَالُوا وَمَنْ لَا عِنْدَهُ مَالُوا فَعَنْهُ النَّاسُ قَدْ مَالُوا. You know, this is just nasheed, but it has meaning. It's in this life, I see most of the people are inclining towards al-mal. You know, they are inclining towards the person who has mal. You have wealth, people will be with you. You don't have wealth, nobody will come, you know. So this man was talking to his friend. He told him, I am better than you in terms of richness and in terms of people also. The community praises me more than the way they talk about you. وَدَخَلَ جَنَّتَهُ وَهُوَ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ. So هذا الرجل كفر. He gets inside his farm as an oppressor to himself, because somebody who is saying this, definitely he is an oppressor. وَهُوَ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ. So he oppressed himself. So one day he gets inside his farm. قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ أَن تَبِيدَ هَذِهِ أَبَدًا. He was so amazed by the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grew it for him. Because of this feelings, he started thinking that this farm will never be gone. قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ أَن تَبِيدَ هَذِي أَبَدًا. He says, I don't think this farm can ever get destroyed at all. خلاص, you know. وَمَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمًا. So he says, when he saw that, mashallah, how beautiful it is, he said, there is no way for this farm to be gone. So that shows how deficient this person is in terms of aql. And that shows how deficient is this person in terms of iman, you know, and the yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was so amazed with the kind of life Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him in this dunya. He thought, you know, that is enough, you know, to have the quality to keep him. And his wealth, you know, can never be taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمًا. So not only that, he even say that, مَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمًا. I don't even think that the day of judgment will happen. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدًا. He thought that his wealth will grant him the life of eternity, whereby he will never die in his life. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, getting rich is okay Islamically, but you have to be very careful. You have to be very careful. Wallahi, you have to be very careful. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted you of richness, you have to be very careful. Make sure that you understand how to deal with it. Otherwise, it will be tragedy. And don't you ever let wealth reach your heart. Always keep it outside. You know, get as much as you wish. Become, as I always mention, the richest person on earth. It is not an issue Islamically. You might get a better Jannah because of that if you give the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your wealth. قَالَ وَمَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمًا. So he says, I don't even believe that the Day of Judgment will happen. And if it is true that the Day of Judgment can possibly take place, وَلَئِنْ رُدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهَا مُنْقَلَبًا. If it is even true that we are going to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I do believe my position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still going to be better than yours. SubhanAllah. Look at Gurur, you know. How much his wealth is deceiving him, you know. وَلَئِنْ رُدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهَا مُنْقَلَبًا. He says, my position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be greater than yours. قَالَ لَهُ صَاحِبُهُ. So after he finished all of these stupidities, you know, his friend, his partner told him, وَهُوَ يُحَاوْرُهُ, and he was conversing with him, أَكَفَرْتَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَكَ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ ثُمَّ سَوَّاكَ رَجُلًا. Do you disbelieve in that who created you from the clay? ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ, and then he turned that clay to a sperm. ثُمَّ سَوَّاكَ رَجُلًا, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fixed you as a man, you know, who is fixed and stable. He said, do you disbelieve in this one who brought you out of nothing and took care of you since you were in the womb of your mother? لَكِنَّهُ وَاللَّهُ رَبِّي وَلَا أُشْرِكُ بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. He says, no. To me, he is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi, the one who created me and control and owns me and owns everything. وَلَا أُشْرِكُ بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. And I will never disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and associate partner with him. So it's like he's telling him, I'm not going to say like you, you know, I'm not going to talk in the way you're talking, but I will say something very different. I do believe in Allah, that He's the one and the only one, and I will never associate partner with Him. And then he go back and started giving him nasiha. He says, وَلَوْلَا إِذْ دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ قُلْتَ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. He said, why not when you get inside your farm, the first thing you did was to appreciate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, MashaAllah. لا قوة إلا بالله. Why didn't you do that? You know, why didn't you make it in this way? That the first thing that happens, that took place from you, that right after you see the farm, you say, MashaAllah, لا قوة إلا بالله. There is no might, there is no power except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the one who granted me this ability to reach this situation. Why can't you refer the blessing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rather than putting it on yourself? ولولا إذ دخلت جنتك قلت ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله إن ترني أنا أقل منك مالا وولدا. He told him, you're just doing whatever you're doing because you see me in comparison to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted you, that I'm lesser in terms of wealth and I'm lesser in terms of people who are surrounding you, whether they're your children or the community. So don't you ever be deceived by that. That shouldn't be the criteria, you know. It shouldn't be the criteria, something we use to measure success with. You cannot measure success with how many people, you know, by how many people you have, how many wealth you have. You know, success cannot be measured by this. قَالَ وَلَوْلَا دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ قُلْتَ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ إِنْ تَرَنِي أَنَا أَقَلَّ مِنْكَ مَالًا وَوَلَدًا. فَعَسَى رَبِّي أَنْ يُؤْتِيَنْ خَيْرًا مِّنْ جَنَّتِكَ وَيُرْسِلَ عَلَيْهَا حُسْبَانًا مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ فَتُصْبِحَ صَعِيدًا زَلَقًا. And he says, I have a hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to grant me better than what He gave you of the Jannah. He gave you those two gardens. He said, I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give me better than what you got. وَيُرْسِلْ عَلَيْهَا حُسْبَانًا مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ. And yours, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to send to it حُسْبَانًا مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ. Allah will send a punishment. حُسْبَان means punishment from the sky. فَتُصْبِحَ صَعِيدًا زَلَقًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take away everything, send a punishment that will take away everything and keep nothing in that place except turab bidun shay, you know, and a very solid, you know, even not soft, solid clay. hard clay. So he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you're not careful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might destroy everything and turn that fertile, you know, land to something which cannot be able to produce anything. So he was reminding him, but unfortunately he refused to take, you know. He said, "Aw yusbiha ba'uha ghawran falan tastati'a lahu talaba." You know, you have the water on the surface. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can take it deep down there, where you cannot be able to get it from down there. So the man told him that either you get this, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take the water down there in a way you cannot be able to bring it up. You know. أَوْ يُسْبِحَ مَاءُهَا غَوْرًا فَلَمْ تَسْتَطِعَ لَهُ طَلَبًا. الْغَوْرُ الْمَاءُ الْغَائِرُ, this is the water that is deep down, you know, so low in a way you cannot easily get it. قال الله تعالى وأحيط بثمره فأصبح يقلب كفيه على ما أنفق فيها وهي خاوية على عروشها ويقول يا ليتني لم أشرك بربي أحدا. سبحان الله. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the punishment in the way that person was warning him. فأصبح يقلب كفيه على ما أنفق فيها. You know, so the thing goes, فَأَصْبَحَ يُقَلِّبُ كَفَّيْهِ عَلَى مَا أَنْفَقَ فِيهَا, means متأسف. He was so sad about what? Now he's not thinking of anything, he's thinking about what he spent on it. How to get back the capital. What happened to I will not die? What happened to my farm cannot be taken away? What happened to my farm cannot be destroyed? You know, all of these are gone. It turns to be illusion. Now the man understands. And regret, where regret cannot benefit him at all. Allah says, وَأُحِيطَ بِثَمَرِي فَأَصْبَحَ يُقَلِّبُ كَفَّيْهِ عَلَى مَا أَنْفَقَ فِيهَا وَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَى عُرُوشِهَا. So he was worrying and so sad about what he spent on it. You know, putting his hand up and down, you know. وَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَى عُرُوشِهَا. And Allah SWT took it to its knees, cut it from the root. Nothing is standing in that form. So he khawitun ala urusha wa yaqulu ya laytani lam ushrik bihi bi rabbi ahada. And subhanallah, at this moment he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he started saying, ya laytani lam ushrik bi rabbi ahada. I wish I did not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that regret would never benefit him, you know. Allah gave him a lot of chances through that brother of his, but unfortunately he burned all of them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَمْ تَكُلْ لَهُ فِئَةٌ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. And at that moment when the farm was destroyed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَمْ تَكُلْ لَهُ فِئَةٌ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. There was nobody who has the capacity to support him other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he destroyed the relationship with Allah. Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ مُنْتَصِرًا. And there is no way for him to be supported. You know, who can support somebody who is under this search of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for him. Who can support him? Nobody. وَلَمْ تَكُلْ لَهُ فِئَةٌ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ مُنْتَصِرًا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ لِلَّهِ الْحَقِّ هُوَ خَيْرٌ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ عُقُبًا. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ لِلَّهِ الْحَقِّ هو خير ثوابا وخير عقبا. So, and this is the walaya, the real walaya. So, if you go for هنالك الولاية, يقول ابن كثير, فيكون المعنى هنالك الموالاة لله عز وجل. أي هنالك كل أحد من مؤمن أو كافر يرجع إلى الله وإلى موالاته والخضوع له. So it means that when the punishment happened, you know, this is the time where everyone will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reflect upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remember him. So that's an approach in the tafsir. أو هنالك الولاية, you know, هنالك الحكم لله الحق, you know, and this means that هنالك الحكم لله, يعني the decision and the decree of what to happen, you know, and what should happen and what will happen is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. nobody shares Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this right. You know, it's a right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to decide what can happen and what should happen at the way, at the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants it to happen. So هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ لِلَّهِ الْحَقِّ. You know, at the moment, this is when the true, you know, picture of each and every one of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether mu'min or kafir, is going to be exposed. So the righteous person will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That punishment will be reminding him about that, the fact that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be holding upon. And the kafir will reflect also, like this person is doing now, when he says, لَيَالَتَنِي لَمْ أُشْرِكَ بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. I wish I did not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is really, really a good reminder for us, you know, to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the times of prosperity. You know, before the punishment come, it might be too late for a person to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know. And although if you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls you to escape the punishment, that would be good for you, but sometimes it doesn't happen that way, you know. So be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you are in a state of prosperity. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will be with you in the times of the hardship. You are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you are okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you when you are in desperate need of His help. قال هنالك الولاية لله الحق هو خير ثوابا وخير عقبا. سبحان الله. If you are looking for good end, is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are looking for the best reward, is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the practical example of the two position that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, which is the hell and paradise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قل الحق من ربكم. Say the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فمن شاء فليؤمن ومن شاء فليكفر. Whoever wants to believe, let him believe. The one who doesn't want to believe, let him go. You know, Allah says, I have a place for anyone who shows arrogance and refuse to accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us an example, a practical example of two people who are making the different choices. One of them chose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the other one chose the dunya, you know. And he lost the dunya at the end of the day and he lost the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, وَلَمْ تَكُنْ لَهُ فِيَةٌ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ مُنْتَصِرًا. So dear brothers and sisters, as I said, it's a very good message for us, you know, for us to understand how to survive in this dunya, you know. Favor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and whatever pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and don't you ever favor the dunya. And make sure that you are next to the good company. You see, this person, he took the wrong people, you know. Those people are not advising him. You know, if they're advising him, he will never be proud of having them, because they will not be proud of him. But it looks like they're not advising him. And that's very serious matter, that the person who should be next to you is somebody who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that if you tilt a bit, that person will remind you about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and bring you back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala peacefully. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَا إِنْ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ فَأَصْبَحَ هَشِيمًا تَذْرُوهُ الرِّيَاحُ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقْتَدِرًا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the example of the dunya. You know, even if this is not given, the example of the farm given to that person is more than enough for us. Green, you know, subhanAllah, everything is so nice and perfect, but then all at sudden Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just take it away. He said, this is dunya. That's why he said, كَمَا إِنْ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ. It's just like the water that we send down from the sky, you know, it mixed with the nabat, the seed, you know, and that the plantation and the crops are generated from it. Allah says, فَأَصْبَحَ هَشِيمًا تَذْرُوهُ الرِّيَاحُ. Then it become completely dry. Something which is dry and so light, and the wind is taking it to several places. Allah says, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقْتَدِرًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the power and ability to do everything. He is the one who is able to do everything at every time. So dunya is like that. It's so green, so nice. But sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will just take it just like this. So if you please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. Even after it is taken from you, you will never lose. Allah will replace it with the best for you. But if you don't please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the end of the day, this dunya is going to be gone. And then you go and face the real tragedy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-mal wal-banuna zinatul hayatul dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the wealth, your wealth, any type of wealth. Wal-banuna, and your children, you know, zinatul hayatul dunya. They are the adornment of this life. And that's true. People are proud of having children. You know, that's a bit nowadays, you know. But they are proud of having money. How many cars you have, how many this and that you have. Allah says, all of these are the pleasure and adornment of this dunya. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ خَيْرٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ أَمَلًا. You know, these are all dunya, but you should know that الْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ Al-Baqiyat al-Salihat, these are the activities that will remain for you, you know, until you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such as the adhkar you're doing. Some scholars said he's referring to the adhkar, you know. So all of this dunya that you have seen in some places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ وَالْقَنَاطِيرِ الْمُقَنْطَرَةِ مِنَ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ وَالْخَيْلِ الْمُسَوَّمَةِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ وَالْحَرْثِ. All of this dunya, women, you know, horses, wealth, and everything, the children that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted a person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-Baqiyatu Salihat Khairun Inda Rabbika Thawaba. It doesn't mean the dunya is evil. You can have all of these that are mentioned as long as it is in a halal way. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you not to favor any of them in a way it is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to focus on that which benefits your akhirah and the dunya. You know. That's why he says, وَالْبَاقِيَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. So try to utilize the dunya to attain the akhirah. That's the smartest decision. Get the dunya and use it as a ladder to reach a better position in the akhirah when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he says, الْمَالُ وَالْبَنُونَ زِنَةُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتِ خَيْرٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ أَمَلًا. So baqiyat salihat generally is talking about the righteous deed, especially the adhkar, and some of these deeds, that whenever you do them, they will act as kafara for your sins, you know. These are the baqiyat salihat. And the same goes to when you have the family and you train the family to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will all be baqiyat salihat, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. قال خير عند ربك ثوابا وخير املا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this is the best, you know, reward, you know, the best in terms of reward you have is the baqiyat salihat, those adhkar, those salawat you're doing, you know, salawat, I mean the salah you're doing, and the charity you're giving, you know, and the knowledge you're learning, you know, marriage upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and give tarbiyah to your spouse, and give tarbiyah to children if you have one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you're looking for the reward, these are the best rewards you can ever get in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ خَيْرٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ أَمَلًا. So if you are looking for the best thing that you are having, you should be having a good hope when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the baqiyatu as-salihat. Okay. As I said, these baqiyatu salihat, they are not restricted to certain types of activities, but they are the righteous deed which usually remains for the benefit of a person after he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَوْمَ نُسَيِّرُ الْجِبَالَ وَتَرَى الْأَرْضَ بَارِزَةً وَحَشَرْنَاهُمْ فَلَمْ نُغَادِرْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. So this is a new topic, and I will stop here inshallah. Tomorrow بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى I will try to come inshallah right after Asr. You know, maybe I will be here before you, before 5 inshallah. So that I can maximize the benefit. I want tomorrow to finish with this issue of the Day of Judgment and also begin with the story of Musa. The story of Musa, we have a lot of lessons to be extracted from that story. So we will be dealing with that inshallah tomorrow if time permits. If not, then in the last class, which is on Thursday, we will be dealing with the story of Musa and Dhulqarnain inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you good and success in life and ease all of your affairs. If you have any question, please do come up with it. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ameen.
Yes. Assalamu
alaikum. Assalamu alaikum.
The brother is gathering charity for the last 10 nights of Ramadan. People send their donations during the night time. The brother collects all the donations and transfers them to the charity organization during his night time. But the brother is in different time zone when he transfers the money. It's already Fajr time for the donors. Would it still count as charity during the night for everyone?
Yeah, if a person already gave it to the brother who is his agent, yeah, that is his agent. Once it reached the charitable organization, inshallah, you know, the point is to reach that place, because charitable organization, they are the agents of the, in this regard, they will be the agents of the needy people to collect on their behalf and pass it to them immediately. Yeah. Inshallah, these type of things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has seen the intention. He should just take the money. You want to give it at night, just give it at night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has recorded the intention, and a person be the light, Allah will never lose the reward he's looking for. Inshallah.
Question by Brother Salim.
As-salamu alaykum, Shaykh. As-salamu alaykum.
He sent the text in Arabic and he wants to know the meaning of it. And it says, فَجَرَّدُوا كَمَا يَحْوَى كِتَابَتُهُ مَا فِيهِ شَكْرٍ وَلَا نَقْتُمْ فَيَحْتِجُوا. So, you know what that means?
No, I don't even get the words.
Yeah, it's very...
فَجَرَّدُوا كِتَابَتُهُ. Okay, let him send it to you together with the source and the context and wherever he get it. It's sometimes cutting just a sentence. A person who is giving interpretation will just give you the literal meaning. That might not benefit. So let him send you later the full text of it. Then. And inshallah, we'll see how to translate it if it is something to be translated, inshallah.
I think that's the last question today. There's no more questions.
Okay, so I advise my dear brothers and sisters, please don't forget we're in the last moment of this month of Ramadan. Don't forget, be serious, you know, and be patient. Maximize the benefit, you know, reduce your sleep. I don't say don't sleep at all, but reduce the sleep. And sleep in the daytime, you know, more than the night, you know. If you want to sleep on the night, at night, then sleep a little, but in the daytime, sleep a lot, you know. Because in the daytime, you're already fasting. You're getting the reward continuously until you finish your fast. But at night, you're not fasting, you know. So, and the nights, they are... more blessed than the days, you know, in the last part of Ramadan. So I really advise you to put a lot of stress on it and don't be stingy to yourself. Read Quran, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do adhkar, make tawbah, repeat a lot, Allahumma innaka afoon, tuhibbul afu wa fa'fu anni, you know, all of these things. And don't forget that you have a lot of need in this life, you know. And also don't forget that we are suffering from this virus. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to remove it. You know, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of you good and success in life. Innahu bi kulli jameelin kafeel. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.